Good morning students, I Professor Rajeshwari Sharma here and I welcome you all to e-learning session of DS College of Commerce, Wardha. So today, this lecture is for the BCom exam and in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the chapter Infrastructure and Transport System in India, which is our last chapter under the second unit. So what we are going to see under this chapter is Meaning of infrastructure, the classification of infrastructure, or we can also call it the types of infrastructure, then the importance or the significance of infrastructure, then the under the transport system, we are going to see the various types of transport system like air transport, water transport, road transport, and the importance of transport system. So let's start with the meaning of infrastructure. What is basically the infrastructure? So, infrastructure means any service or the facilities that helps in smooth functioning of an economy. We will understand the meaning of infrastructure through some examples. If we talk about the time period of some decades ago, like 70 or 80 years ago, so what used to happen? If I want to go to Nagpur from Wardha, so how much time it would have taken if I use the bullock cart? Probably 2 or 3 days, right? As we have the distance of 86 kilometers. But today, with the availability of transport, with the availability of roads, with the availability of various modes of transport like trains, vehicles, etc., we can cover that distance, or we can reach from Wardha to Nagpur within 2 or 1.5 hour. So this is the impact of infrastructural development on our lives. If some decades ago again, I want to convey a message to somebody who is living in Mumbai, so how much time it would have taken? It could have taken a week, it could have taken 3 to 4 days, right? But today, I can give them message within a second, within the minutes. How? I can make the phone call, I can send them email, I can message them through various means, right? So how it has become possible? All this has become possible due to infrastructural development, right? So this is how the infrastructure plays crucial role in the development and the growth of any economy. So now we will see the different classifications of infrastructure. So first one is, it is divided into 3 parts, that is economic infrastructure, social infrastructure and the financial infrastructure. When I talk about the economic infrastructure, so what is basically the economic infrastructure? Economic infrastructure includes all those services and the facilities which facilitates or promotes production and the distribution of goods and services. Now, what are the different facilities or the services which promotes production and the distribution of goods and services? So, if I talk about the production, so what is required for production? Energy, power, right? Without power, is production in the any industry possible without power or energy? Of course no. So power is one of the important facilities which facilitates the production. Okay, now it's about production. Now once the goods have been produced in the industries, now for making them available to the consumers, for taking those goods to the market, what is needed? The transportation facilities, right? So the transportation also helps in connecting the roads, also helps to improve connectivity, which promotes or facilitates the distribution. Then when we talk about the energy, transportation, etc., so all this comes under the economic infrastructure. So what is basically the economic infrastructure? Economic infrastructure consists of all those services and facilities which promotes production and the distribution of goods and services. The next one is social infrastructure. So, what is basically the social infrastructure? See, when we talk about the economic infrastructure, so it promotes the industrial development. It creates the employment. But when we talk about the social infrastructure, so it is the infrastructure which consists of various services and facilities which helps to improve quality of human resource, because good quality human resource is an asset to the economy. They can contribute in economic growth. They can contribute in economic development. So good quality human resource can be considered as an asset of economy. So when we talk about the social infrastructure, so social infrastructure consists of all those facilities and services which helps to improve quality of human resource. Like here we can give the example of education. In every budget, the fund allocation is made for the various schemes related to education. Like Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is there, which is run by the government for providing free education to the children who are aged between 6 to 14 years. That is one of the example of the social infrastructure, like free education by the way of through the schools for the children, right? So there are various schemes which are launched by government for the education sector. So it comes under the social infrastructure. When the people are going to be educated, they are going to be skilled, they are going to have the knowledge, so they can contribute more and more in the process of economic development of the country. When we talk about the health, so it also comes under the social infrastructure. Like the fund allocation is made for the health as well. It is given to the people. It is provided. The various schemes are being provided to the people so that they can get the various facilities related to the health, which improves the quality of human resource. Like you must have heard about the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. Ayushman Bharat Yojana. So that is also one of the scheme which helps to develop the social infrastructure in the country. So when we talk about the social infrastructure, so it consists of the various facilities and services which leads to quality of human resource. Then next one is financial infrastructure. When we talk about the financial infrastructure, so it consists of the banks, insurance, non-banking financial institutions or non-banking financial companies, the money market, capital market, etc. Now how this financial infrastructure is helpful? See, if you are running a business and you are in need of credit, so you can approach the bank. When you are running a business, so obviously every business has a risk. Every business is associated with uncertainty. So in that case, you can get your business insured. You can get your goods insured so that risk and the losses can be minimized, or risk and the losses can be avoided. So in this way, financial infrastructure helps in the growth and the development of the business. So these are the different types of infrastructure. Now we will move towards the importance of infrastructure. So first one over here is smooth functioning of an economy. Now how the infrastructure helps in smooth functioning of an economy? See, for smooth functioning of an economy, what is needed? Economic growth is needed, economic development is needed, right? So when we talk about the economic infrastructure, right, so what does it consist of? It consists of the various services and the facilities which promotes the industrial growth, like transport, communication, the energy, power, etc. So when all these facilities gets developed in the economy, so it also leads to the industrial growth. It also leads to the industrial progress, which leads to the economic growth. Then when we talk about the social infrastructure, so what does social infrastructure consist of? It consists of health, it consists of education, And when all these facilities are being provided, so it leads to the improvement of human resources. And when there is improvement of human resources in a country, so it creates the asset for economy. It creates the human capital for economy, which contributes to the growth and the development of the economy. So development in various areas or various type of infrastructure leads to the smooth functioning of an economy. The next one is development of agriculture. See, when we talk about the agriculture, so when the agriculture products are being produced, so due to the development of infrastructure, the market for the agricultural product gets wider because transport facilities are available. The agricultural product, there are various insurance products which are available for the agriculture sectors too. So the risk of the farmers can be minimized. Then when we talk about the credit, if the agricultural sector is in need of credit, they require the credit for the purpose of the farming, so they can approach the banks for the loan, and the different schemes are also provided for them by way of the banking sector. So this way, when the infrastructure, different types of infrastructure like economic infrastructure, financial infrastructure gets developed in the nation, so it also helps the sectors like agricultural to become developed. So in this way, it helps in development of agriculture. The next one is development of industry. When we talk about the industry, so it is generally associated with the production of goods and services. So for production of goods and services, do we only require the man and the machines? Of course not. For the development of the industries, we require the market. We require the marketing, we require the various tools of marketing. We require the various tools by the way of which the risk can be minimized, and by the way of infrastructural development in the country, these facilities can be provided. Even though your plant has been located in some area which is away from the city, which is away from your marketplace, so you can get connected to it by way of transport. You can get your business insured and minimize the risk. You can again approach to the banks for the credit. You can make investment in the different markets. When the financial infrastructure gets developed, so in this way, infrastructural development also helps in the development of the industry. The next one is promotion of investment. See, if there are two countries, country A and country B, right? Country A is having good infrastructural facilities. They are having good transportation facilities. The credit facilities are also available in that country. They are having good financial infrastructure. They are having the good quality of human resource due to good social infrastructure. And the country B is a country whereby the power is expensive, whereby the good transportation facilities are not available, whereby the roadways are not built in a proper manner, whereby the transportation cost is high due to improper conditions of the roadways and the and improper availability of the means of transport. So which country will you choose, or which location will you choose for setting up of your business or for making the investment? Of course, the country A, having the good infrastructural facilities, having good transportation, having good human resource, having good financial infrastructure like banking, insurance, etc. So in this way, when the infrastructure gets developed in the economy, infrastructure gets developed in a country, so it also attracts investment. I hope it's clear. Now next one is improvement in productivity. See, when there will be improvement in the productivity, when you are going to have the good quality of human resource, right? And if your social infrastructure is getting improved, the human resource of your country is healthy, the human resource of your country is skilled, they are available at the cheaper rate. They are making good contribution. They are showing the good productivity. In that case, the productivity of the sector will increase, right? So due to the development of the infrastructure, in the economy, the productivity of human resource also increases, which leads to the increase the overall productivity of the industry. So in this way, it helps to improve the productivity. The next one is employment generation. When I talk about the employment generation, when the roads or the highways are being made, so it will provide the employment opportunities to the people, right? Because for the construction of the roads, the labors will be needed, the material will be needed, which needs to be bought from some place. So there also the employment which will be manufactured somewhere, so there also the employment opportunity will be created. When the infrastructure is being developed, the connectivity is being improved, so in that way the opportunity for tourism sector will also increase, and this tourism sector will also create some jobs for the people. So in this way, when the financial infrastructure is being improved in the country, more and more banking companies are being set up, more and more insurance companies are being set up. Due to the industrial growth, due to cope up with the needs of industry, so this sectors, the service sectors will also provide job to the people. So in this way, when the infrastructural development occurs in the country, so it also leads to employment generation. So infrastructural development is also important for employment generation. It plays a crucial role in employment generation. And the last one is development of backward region. See, there is some backward region whereby the farming is being done. Now the products have been produced. Okay, products have been produced. But if the infrastructural facilities would not have been so developed, there would have been no connectivity of that backward region to the roads. So market for that backward region would have been so narrow, right? If there would be no availability of credit in that region, so what would have happened? They would have faced the problem of the capital deficiency, so that they cannot bring improvement to the methods of their production. They cannot achieve the desired result. So when the infrastructural development happens, generally the connectivity of the backward regions also increases due to improvement of economic infrastructure, due to improvement in social and the financial infrastructure. Connectivity to the backward region also increases, due to which the backward region gets connected to the other developed regions, because of which they also leads towards the path of development. So this way, infrastructure plays very crucial role in the development of the economy. So for today we have learned the meaning of infrastructure, the classification of infrastructure, and the importance of infrastructure. In our next lecture, we are going to see the transport system. Till then, keep going through the lectures, stay safe, and keep studying. Thank you.